Sacre bleu! It's a French tank.
Stop. Hold on. I need to stop the video and make an apology here. I need to apologize to everybody that is French or French speaking for what just happened. I know that's not a saying that's actually said in France, and it was very poorly pronounced. So my apologies. All right, back to the video.
Here's something you don't see every day. A Renault FT17 tank. This little guy is over 100 years old. Well, the real one was. So let's print this bad boy. The FT-17 rolled onto the scene in 1917 during World War I. The armies were desperately trying to figure out how to cross trenches without becoming human Swiss cheese. The French said, "What if we put some armor on it, slap a gun on top, and make it look like a teapot on tracks?" Boom! The FT-17. At the time, most tanks were giant metal rhinos that needed an entire crew and a bottle of aspirin to steer. The FT-17 was different. It was small, had just two crew members, one to drive and one to shoot, and it introduced something revolutionary. The fully rotating turret. That's right, no more doing a full three-point turn just to point your gun at the enemy. You could spin around like a ballerina with a bad attitude problem. Of course, being inside wasn't exactly luxurious. The driver sat practically in the engine's lap, and the gunner had about as much elbow room as someone stuck in economy seating on a budget airline. Throw in engine fumes, heat, and the occasional artillery shell, and you've got yourself the worst Airbnb ever. But the FT-17 worked. It was tough, reliable, and surprisingly mobile for the time. By the end of the war, thousands were built. Other nations quickly copied the design. And honestly, every tank since then owes a family resemblance to this awkward little French box on tracks. So yeah, the Renault FT-17 might look small and kind of cute today, but in 1917, it was a game changer, the godfather of all modern tanks. And now, thanks to my 3D printer, it lives again. Only this time, it won't be storming trenches. It'll probably just sit on my shelf, silently judging me for not printing it in camouflage.